Hello, ladies and gentlemen, Captain Shaq here, and welcome back to Republic at War. I'm leading the clone armies to victory, damn it. If it takes me a year, I'm gonna do it. Alright, so where do we leave off last episode? We had the Republic fleet, the Mighty Fleet. We're gonna call this the First Fleet. So the First Fleet has made its way over to Endor, and we actually managed to capture it, and I think we've kind of stomped out all the resistance that we're gonna get out here in this, what is this? This is the Western Outer Rim? Yeah, pretty sure. So I figure we'll just do what we were doing before. We'll take the fleet, we will knock out the defenses of these two planets, and then begin the ground invasion. And then we had a secondary fleet that we were just starting to do hit-and-run tactics with. Here we go. Yeah, they were on the way from Dothamir over to Yavin 4, and what we were going to do was take out any type of resistance that they've got here. They've got a small fleet here, and kind of pop star bases. And pick up some Jedi. These Jedi have been stuck here for quite some time, so that was the plan. Now, I gotta be careful where I send this fleet. I kind of feel like we need to get a scout out here. That way I don't run this fleet into an enemy force that's like three or four times its size. Because, like, look down here. We've got Mon Cal, capable of producing capital ships. We've got Mintuni, right? I'm pretty sure capable of producing cap ships. It's got a level 5 space station on it. There's another, that's a level 3 space station. But there's quite a bit of capital production in this one little sector. So chances are they've got a fleet out there that are going to be a problem. But I do like the idea, the concept of us building multiple fleets to start engaging. Let's check our production levels right now and see how the galactic economy is doing. So Coruscant, of course, is building more cap ships for us. Venators are being constructed. The shipyards are going full steam ahead. What are we going to do? Was I gonna build a level 5 space station here? Kind of expensive. We're broke right now. Our galactic credit reserves are non-existent, but day 95 is almost upon us. We should have some more credit. So let's get to the fight. We're gonna keep moving this fleet, and then we need to choose where we wanna send them. But for now, let's focus on getting this area secure. I'm gonna click resume, get the fleet moving. Understood. Holy crap, are you going slow? Oops, that's a zoom in.
Tactical battle imminent.
Excellent. Oh, bummer. So they pulled their one ship out of there. We do have some support ships orbiting, pretty much heavy artillery guns. We're gonna auto-resolve that. We only killed one. This is why I don't like auto-resolving.
Tactical battle.
Let's pause. Oh, the fleet has arrived. What? The fleet has arrived and it's actually landed into an enemy force, like a sizable force. Now I wonder if this is all fighting units. Let's resume game, let's start a battle. I wonder if this is actually fighting units or if we caught an enemy ground fleet on the move. I kind of hope it's a ground fleet, but we'll see. A good fight for the first fleet would be nice. Bakura. Oh, look at it. It's so pretty. Launch off fighters.
Intel says
give the fleet
a
minute to get into full combat readiness. It's gotta be a tough job to dig them all around. All right, let's start moving the Pride of the Core up.
Understood. Acknowledged.
Look at the planet in the background. This is what we're fighting for. Fighting to capture this planet.
Roger that.
All right. Let's get our fighter wing up. Move it forward.
Ready. Affirmative.
So I've got interesting news. As of this morning, I've decided that I'm gonna be going to the Star Wars celebration between, I think it's the 16th and the 19th. I have to check my dates. But I'm going to be there. And if you guys are going to be there, then let me know. And, like, jump onto my Twitter is actually the best way to do it. Because I'm going to, when I'm there, what I'm going to try to do, and I'm going to be there for all 4 days, let's just get every fighter we've got moving up. Let's just move the entire fleet forward.
What is your order?
Let's get aggressive with this. I'm going to try to set up, like, a meet and greet.
B-Wing Squadron.
For anybody who's going to be there who watches the channel, shake hands, talk Star Wars for a bit. I'm really looking forward to it. They're going to have a playable copy of Battlefront there. And hopefully I will be able to report back to you guys. Oh, hang on. Just wait here. Let's let them move their fleet in.
Yes, Commander. Transmission received.
You have your orders, man. Let's get the arcs up here. Let's get all anti-fighter.
Ready for
fighters
orders.
Moving up. Is the fleet on the move? Yes, the Pride of the Corps taking point. That's the way I like it. This thing can suck up the damage. Honestly, it could take it. Look at the fighters, the field of fighters. They look like little specks. But in reality, it's this. I love the scale of this game. It's so good. But we still don't have any contact with the enemy. Why aren't they engaging us? All right, V-Wings, clear the path. Look at them, look at them. They're just sitting there. They're like, they're actually, this is really smart of them. Sit there and wait until they have every one of their guns within range. All right, let's go ahead and engage.
Vector set.
Copy. How much firepower they're putting on our fighters.
I've got something. Swinging around.
It's too much of a death trap. Let's wait until the primary fleet can engage.
Yes, General.
We're drawing ready for your orders.
Let's go ahead and overload the weapons. We'll be able to take a lot of their support ships out with the Pride. Let's take this battle group up and around the right-hand side. So you guys have orders now. You'll be moving a little bit faster than the Pride.
What is your order?
What are your orders?
Yes, sir.
All right, come on around here. You guys should be dealing with... There we go. Let's bring up the arcs. Arcs can just slam a couple of the support units. Cover them. And take out the bombers before they become a threat. We're looking pretty good. We're looking pretty good. But yeah, I'm really looking forward to that. Like, they're going to have a closed doors session with Battlefront. And I'm looking forward to trying it. I've got my reservations right now. After Hardline came out and the things that I've heard about Hardline. I hate to say this, but I'm actually gonna be playing Hardline soon because I'm doing a video on for TGN on how they need to really be careful. EA really needs to be careful about what they do with Battlefront. They could lose a lot of goodwill. DICE could if they screw up one of the best Star Wars franchises. All right, guys, come on, I need the heavy guns in range. You guys should have been in range like 10 minutes ago. Glad to see your cannons are in range, but you're like the only one. Alright, we're actually looking really good. Another support ship is down, more or less disabled. Let's go ahead and leave him be. Oh, we can't leave anywhere until we take out the hangar base. Alright, just destroy it. There's so much firepower there. Alright, get it done. Here's the primary battle group. Get in there. Get aggressive, guys. It's the whole point of you dudes coming up to the right-hand side. I need you in range. And our southern battle group needs to move. Move your ass. I thought they'd have a bigger unit here. So I'm gonna be playing Hardline because it's going to be the same engine. Not the same development team, of course. I don't think it was DICE who made Hardline, though I haven't done my research yet. But I'm gonna be doing a comparison video on like the pitfalls of these like Battlefield knockoffs. And how Battlefront needs to be different. I mean, you're dealing with people's childhood favorite franchises here. You need to do it right. And there's certain things about the Battlefront series, I think, that were very unique to it specifically that need to be dealt with. All right, we're looking good. The fleet's actually doing pretty well. Let's overload all the guns now. We should have everybody within range. So let's load up everything we got. And let's remove the space station from existence. That would make me very happy. Let's get the beam cannons in range. Looking good, looking good. How's the Pride doing? Your shield's still up? Your shields are still up. Good, good, good. Another support ship is down. And we are wrecking their space station. Look at this guy. He's like right in the middle of the action. Look at the rounds in every direction. It's chaos. It would be so scary to be a fighter pilot in the middle of this. Because you never know when you're going to take a stray round from one of the giant turbo batteries. Insanity, I love it. There goes the space station. All right, mop it up, boys. Come on, find those droids, take them down. But I'm curious what you guys think. Like, the one thing that I've loved about Battlefront is the amount of content that they just jam-packed packed that game with. One and two. You had the Clone Wars era, right? So that means you have all these units from the Clone Wars, the Clone Troopers, the Spec Ops guys. Then you had everything from the original series. Are we really like hunting guys when we know we have targets right here? Find and destroy them. Go hunt them. Get it done. Send a few units this way. Close your wings. Go that way. And so it was full of content. Then they, especially two. Oh man, two had so much going for it. All right, take these guys out. There's like one guy left. There's literally one unit left. One fighter. So you had all that. You had a ton of maps. You had the different game modes, the heroes, the just so much. Now the question is, how do you balance it? Because there was a lot of issues with the balance in Battlefront 2. As much as I love that game, then you had the campaign, and the campaign actually told the story in 2 of the clone trooper unit, Vader's finest, which was really cool to see that transition and then hear the voiceover from Django, you know, the clones, from the actual
tactical
clones.
Battle. Imminent.
What do we got? Really? Back here? What is... Seriously? Like, this is our tactical battle? All right, let's begin it. I'm not auto-resolving it, because for all I know, it'll just like, nah, you lose. I think I can win this. So I believe they're going to be doing nothing but the original movies, and maybe a little bit for the movies, the new movie that's coming out. A Force Awakens, but that's the question. It's like, do they do the Clone Wars stuff? Do they do it as an expansion? And is that acceptable for them to do the Clone Wars era as an expansion? I think it is. I think it's fine, to be honest. As long as what they release is, you know, the full game. It's full content. And it's done really, really well. Interesting game modes. They do a campaign that's fun and tells a tale, you know, actually tells a story would be fun, would be nice. I mean, they're given one of the richest franchises in history, one of the richest fictional universes to play with. And if they don't come up with something really, really fun and interesting, especially for a group, DICE actually went out of their way to say, hey, look, we want to make Battlefront. Because DICE, it can do whatever the hell they want. Because they're just a license to print money for EA. They really are. Take them down. We shall see. Hey, come on now. Focus the main cannons on the capital ship. Let's overload them, and let's get a beam cannon fire on that shield generator. All right, we're going to be broadsiding them. The biggest advantage that we have in this fight is our bombers. We've got those ARC 170s. They're going to wreck them. Can we get that beam shot now? There you go. Why did we not take the shield generator down? Oh, this isn't even fair. The bulwark doesn't have a chance. Destroy the... See the cannons firing away? Oh, that is good. I just wish I had more homeworld-esque control, right? So I could, like, rotate the cap ship that I've got here so all the cannons can fire. Like, what happens if I turn him? I don't really need to, but what happens if I turn you? Can I turn you around? Come on, turn for me. Doesn't matter, it's already dead. I was gonna see if I could turn it and see if all the cannons would fire forward. Because they do in the show.
Orders received.
You're not gonna find it, but there's a good victory. I'll take that. They must have been retreating or something. I didn't even know there was a picket there. We must have blown that up coming in. I'm gonna take the fleet, this tiny little fleet, and go over here and stomp out this Confederacy fighter group as well. Let's get the ground troops moving, though. Let's get this done.
Construction complete.
Ready for battle, sir. Acknowledged.
Swap it out.
Construction complete.
And let's move you.
Enemy fleet approaching.
Enemy fleet approaching.
Imminent.
Ooh, they've got another group. Sizable too, and a space station. All right, let's do it. We're getting work done today. Taking out these planets. I think we finally, we've come around that quarter. And I'm really starting to hammer them.
Hard contact.
Hard contact. The droid army doesn't have a chance. What the hell is this? interesting line, Intel though says there could be as much as a full the line isn't engaging us. They're running. Tough job to fight! Come at us!
Yes, sir.
Overload the guns. Really make them pay for it. Let's move the
ready
group.
For your orders. Coordinates received.
As you let's move us right in. Look at that, we're taking out their shields. What is he doing? He's just sitting there.
Roger.
Let me get a V-Wing and an arc run on this guy. Let's just take him out. Don't let him escape.
Roger that. Ready.
No, you're not the unit that I wanted to focus on. You are. You're not even going to get within range to drop your bombs. Whew. So many units. What I'd really like to see, though, in Battlefront, we're talking about that specifically, is the a new type of multiplayer game mode that focuses on communities. You know? Like, a cooperative campaign is something I would love to see. I would really, really love to see. Come on, guys. You guys are on hunt. Target fighters, take them out. We're going to use you to take out their support units, so let's just bring this whole arc wing around. Battle group 2, get down here. I want you to focus all your weapons. Get all your cannons firing at their carriers. Let's take them down. Completely unmolested arc squadron. Say goodnight. Take out his engine so he can't get away. Seriously, we didn't take your shield generator down? Get it done. He's more or less disabled and still completely unmolested. This is fantastic. Let's overload the cannons and open fire, men. Destroy them. All of them. All right, support ship is down. Secondary support ship, you guys are already lined up for it. You might as well take it down. You're free to target any subsystem. Drop them. Oh, it's just mean. All right, let's take out their primary tech unit. Let's get into the arc viewpoint. Oh, look at the gunfire everywhere. Turbo lasers going to town. All right, we've got torpedo lock. We've got tone. Missiles away. Somebody give these men a medal. Beautiful. All right, boys. I need to take the shield generator out, and I don't actually need all of you to do it. Let's grab, like, some of you. Take out the hangar base. Still got carriers online here? Come on. There's no reason you guys should still be alive and kicking. Let me get some cannon fire on this ship. Take out a shield generator. Get it done. Looking good. When I'm talking about cooperative campaigns, I keep getting distracted by the battle that's going on. It's actually pretty much in the bag, I think. Take him out. All arc fighters, you've got your target.
I read you, General.
Actually, there's one right here. Take him out. Don't let him get away. So here's what I was thinking, right? You do the cooperative campaign, like the Galactic map. They had this campaign mode that you could play where you just played random matches on the planet surface, right? But make it for a community of like 30 or 60. So we could get everybody on the channel. Everybody who wanted to play some co-op. One person plays command mode. They've always had a commander mode. And then you have the rest of the game going, where you have your squads of troopers. Maybe they're clone troopers. Maybe they're your stormtroopers. You've got your pilots. You've got to do the space invasion first. You've got your overmap. And the guy playing commander says, okay, we're going to be taking this point and this point. Pretty much me playing like Republic at War. And I would record it or I would live stream it for the community, and then everybody who's on the server dives into the matches, the individual battles like you're seeing right here. So imagine this battle going on, but with you guys playing as the units, right? The arcs, the two-man arc fighters. Let's zoom in on one of them real quick. Let's grab this bomber. Okay, let's use this viewing. So you got two guys in this fighter, and they're actually players playing and fighting against the AI. And the units that we field are based on the resources that we've gathered, or the tech that we've researched. It would just be so much fun. And the idea of being built around a large-scale community like that, never been done before. Return to the galactic map. That was an absolute victory in every way. Our next battle. Notice in this episode that we are starting every fight so far. That's a big difference. I think that's a good sign for us to be in the fight. That's what I'm talking about, though. I really want to see them do more than just, hey, this is Battlefield with a Star Wars skin. I want to see more than that. I really do. As much fun as that will be, and there needs to be, you know, the traditional conquest mode. That's what I would love to see. Something a little bit longer. It'll be interesting what they come up with. Alright, should we just be fighters, guys, so just get in there. Find the target. Let's go. Frigate at your disposal.
We've got company.
All right, there they are. Engage, 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 engage. Split off two groups. Let's do the dogfight. We're on them. So you've got that kind of scale and that kind of persistence, right? So you've got a campaign that's running. And then here's where it would be really fun. The unlock system of Battlefield. Have that. So the more you guys play in the campaign with the community, and I would make this server specific, the more you play like with me, with the community, the more shit you will unlock that you can use in the battles. Now, if you could go even in more into depth with this, you could have units inside of the community be built. You could have squadrons where if you play with certain people, certain units that you played with before, you'll start getting bonuses. Maybe I can award like medals that give you a bonus to whatever damage, to whatever units you can use, whatever you have access to. Give the game a little bit more a feeling of persistence. So the guys who love playing the Spec Ops dudes. And this is another idea that they could do with it too.
Invasion commencing.
You know how I can do raids in Republic at War here? Well, what if I could do raids with 5-man teams and people who like to play as the ARC troopers? They end up getting the Mass Effect multiplayer, almost cooperative experience. Let's go ahead and begin this battle. Wow, they've got a lot of ground troops. I gotta watch out with this. This could be bad. But you could have that cooperative small man Spec Ops unit. They could sneak in and soften up defenses, especially if it's a cooperative match against AI, which the AI have a very strategic, more real-time strategy AI to them and less Call of Duty, you know, where it's just like, corridor shooting. Where the AI actually worries about resources and capture points. And all right, let's pause this real quick. We've only got 5, but there are 2 landing zones that we can use on this map, and we have the perfect units to go capture them. I'm thinking I'm going to split these guys up, 2 here, 2 here. At the same time, we'll bring in... Oh, man, I am really wary about bringing in Delta Squad at this point. We don't know what's on this planet yet. We won't bring in Delta because we don't want to lose Delta. Not this early. We will drop in, I'm thinking, a Field Commander, which will give our troops health, and then let's just drop in a bunch of ground troops. Let's get it done. Run. I need to use up these squads anyways. These guys are kind of low tech. We really don't need these small squads. We need to be replacing these guys with bigger units. How you doing? Alright, looks like the locals are enemy specific. You wonder why I'm putting out AA? I'm very paranoid about their attack units. Oh shit. Go boys, go. So yeah, that's why I put down AA, right there. I hate those damn things.
Our position is secure.
Get that AA planted.
We do our job well.
We're gonna bring in some armor the second we have the chance.
You can't negotiate with droids.
Construction complete.
We are capping. We are now. Second we do, we're gonna drop in some armor. I think drop in armor right here and hard rush for the base. Do as much damage as we can.
We've secured a landing zone.
Sir, yes, sir.
Let's do it.
Never surrender.
We do have the air. Oh shit, how did you guys take damage? They must have brought in that air. Alright, give him more vision, so let's spread out. Got our command unit. Tanks are on the ground. Shit. Get over here. And you guys get moving. So how much damage do you do to... Not much. Please, this. Run. Oh, I killed it. Alright, you guys just go. Get the damage done. Rush in.
Destroyed. We've secured a
unit destroyed. Still can't build. Spread it out. They have a very large area of effect. Maybe we'll get lucky. Maybe they'll be able to get the turret online. Oh my god! What is that? Did you guys see that? There's like 1,000 of them.
We're ready for battle, sir. Understood.
Oh,
General.
What are we gonna do with this?
Sir, yes, sir.
We also didn't take this top point.
Construction complete.
We got it up.
Watch the rear.
This is a problem.
Never give
this is a big problem. What the hell are we gonna do? Alright, I got an idea.
Sir.
Rudd.
Audit, sir.
How are we doing on cash? We did get paid. Looks like the galactic day went by. Let's run away. This is gonna be a problem. It's gonna be a major problem. Oh!
Let's go.
Stop shooting at me! Oh, and we got locals shooting at us? Shit.
Let's move on.
They took out my AA. Ooh. Damn, damn, damn.
Our position is secure. We do our job well.
Reinforce them.
Unit destroyed.
I'm thinking we do have the... Oh, we don't have any units in the air. Shit. I didn't leave any support units in air because I really didn't think they'd have this much. This is a problem.
This battle isn't over until we scrap the last
I'm trying to think of what I can do here.
Never surrender.
This is going to be tough. Oh, you're still alive? Shit. Right. Nope. If I move you, the air units are going to wreck you. Oh, shit.
Move out, men.
This is a problem. We do hit and run with the saber tanks. See what kind of damage we can do.
Copy that, General.
There's about 20 of these fucking spider walkers. Man. We're gonna need some serious firepower. Yay! There goes their air unit. Hopefully that's their last one.
I'm
gonna start hitting using those hit and run tactics. Let's go. We don't want them grouping up too badly. Oh, we don't have any air. If we had the airstrike, if I would have brought in support. Now we can still retreat. I do have a landing pad here. Oh, look at you. Run. That sucks. Run. There we go. Damn. Yeah, put fire on
him.
Let's take out this air unit. I noticed some of my sounds aren't working. That's a little weird. Map's bugged or something. Focus fire on him.
Copy that.
How much firepower can these things? These take so much. And they've got another air unit in the zone.
Roger that, sir.
Two choices, retreat or stay here and fight to take this one out.
Yes, General.
Retreat.
Copy that, General.
Pull him underneath the air. Holy crap.
Prepare to engage the enemy. We're ready for battle, sir.
All right, we don't have a choice. We've got to retreat.
Combat is a clone's natural element.
They're dug in too greatly,
sir.
In here.
Prepare to engage the enemy.
Unit
glad I didn't bring
destroyed.
Delta in here.
Unit destroyed.
Not gonna happen. Well, now we know.
We have been defeated.
That was unexpected. It looks like all they've been producing on this, all they've been doing on this planet is producing the spider walkers. So, you have been defeated. Ouch. We're gonna have to replenish our ground troops big time. Let's pause real quick. This is another problem. This is a big problem. Do we waste the resources and time to take this? It'll give us a reduced time on repulse or lift vehicles, but I don't plan on building too many more saber tanks. Or do we just leave a ship in orbit, or a unit in orbit, keep them from building, keep them locked in here? I think that's the better move. We don't have to conquer every single planet, but what we need to do is break the enemy's ability to fight. And I think that's the way of doing it. I think we've got some ARC troopers. We need to start disseminating these, get them out into the field. Let's devise you up too.
Tactical battle imminent.
Oh, what do we got? The enemy has brought another tank at us. Let's auto resolve that. Fantastic. And let's pause real quick. We can move one of our Jedi, and I was thinking about moving Shakti. We're gonna do that. You're gonna join the fleet. You are now commander
tactical
of the fleet.
Battle imminent.
Seriously? You guys gonna keep trickling ships in here? Oh man, Mandalore only has... Okay, actually Mandalore's got a sizable group there, and we don't know what it is, and they've got a large level 5 space station. So if I go there, I've got to go there willing to fight. What do we got? Providence class. Let's begin. Make sure it doesn't retreat. Gotta make sure we get this thing rocked. Okay. Begin the fight. Our little battle group here It's actually been causing them a lot of trouble.
What's my destination?
I agree. Let's move.
We've got trouble. Be on the alert for droids.
Where is our hero? There she is. In her command, her flagship. Looking good, looking good. Engage engines, let's move the fleet.
Give me a target.
Da-da, da-da, da-da.
All out.
Yes, sir. Copy that, sir.
Beginning construction.
Sure, we'll turn that into a repair station. Works for me.
Direction received.
Locate the enemy. Capture that base. Come on now. They've got to have their unit around here somewhere. There we go. We've got contact. Where at? Just a few fighters. Let's sweep in that direction. Chances are it's where they're at.
Yes, General. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
The fleet will hold. They'll be fine.
Almost there, General.
We're on it, General.
Roger. Keep going.
Got him. Roger. There's the target.
Attack that target.
Engage their engines. Arcs are going to clear the way, and they're going to take out his shield generator. Take out the shield generator. Torpedoes are away. Nice. So, I recently spotlighted a game called Star Drive 2, and I talked about this in the last episode, but there's been new developments in this. So this comes out, as of recording this, it comes out in 2 days, Star Drive 2. It's a 4X strategy game with real-time space battles and a turn-based ground battle system. It is pretty fun. It's made by one guy. And he's done more than most of these big companies trying to make these 4X games, these bigger ones. It is fun. But here's what he did. On release day, right, there's going to be a full guide. There's already guides, full suite of tools to make your own mods for the game. The videos he's made to show how to mod, he modded in the Galaxy class from Star Trek. Like, just as the demo. And he's going to be giving, because his first game, Star Drive 1, had a total conversion Star Wars or Star Trek mod. Total conversion, so it made the whole world into Star Trek. He's going to give the tools early to the guy who made that mod, so hopefully we'll have a Star Trek total conversion on day one release for his game. How cool is that? Target destroyed, fantastic. We're doing well. I kind of want to keep these guys on the move. I'm a little concerned. And this fleet isn't actually that bad. We could actually have a huge victory if we can take Mandalore, at least in space. Or I could move my smuggler as a scout. That's the perfect scout, move the smuggler around. Like, we might be able to win this, but it would be a hard-won fight. And that's not what this fleet is about. This fleet is about picking at them. So that's what we're gonna do. Let's resume Vital. Let's move you to Korriban.
Shuttle en route.
I want you to check it out for us, and be quick about it. I'm actually going to keep this fleet on the move, so let's move you... Oh, there's only one way that way? Okay, we'll wait. How are we doing back here? Our ground troops have severely got their ass kicked. Let's go to Kamino. Let's start replenishing the troops. We got the 501st. We have the 501st. Let's get... Debating what I want to do here. We need to replenish our ground troops. We've got an enemy fleet. Get out of here. Get out of here.
Vehicle.
Get a couple more scout units. Now, why am I building scout units? Because this is the planet where we've got our siege battalion, the 442nd. We've also got artillery. They've been holding this for a while now. A couple of siege units will make those artillery super effective. We've got a massive enemy fleet. It's all ground troops. Oh, man. I could pull these guys over there. I could pull the main fleet. I could pull the first fleet. Head south. Attack this and completely wipe out their largest ground army I think I've ever seen. 21 super battle droids and a couple droidicas. That would be pretty gnarly. We could actually take them right across Naboo. That wouldn't be that bad. We could pull that off. They don't have much in the way of... And we could have this one ship clear the path. So they can fly right through. Let's do it. Let us do it. So we're going to get the main fleet moving. We need to drop a single unit here. Pause. We're going to move the main fleet. We gotta get a unit here. Can we leave anything out of this fleet here? Not really, no. Can't afford to leave anything. So, what we're gonna do, resume, give me you. You, get over here. Damn, we're under attack. Looks like a fairly substantial ground invasion. Commanded by Dirge. That's actually a pretty good sized group, and these homing spider droids could give us trouble. Oof. If anybody can hold this planet, it's the siege battalion backed up with heavy artillery. Right when we're sending you reinforcements to. Oh man, they have to hold out. I don't want to lose this planet. It's a pain in the butt to siege because the enemy always like spreads their units out. What do we got back here at their base? A couple of turrets. Good. Good. Cause them some trouble.
Watch the rear.
Here's the siege battalion. Got to take a look at them real quick. It's like we've been on this mud ball of a planet, this piece of crab desert planet for so long. We're ready to get the hell out of here. But we fight and die for the Republic.
We'll follow you anywhere, sir.
Where's our artillery? Oh, this is that planet where they always spread the artillery. One of my complaints is that these guys... Actually, that's my fault. I can move these. These artillery are always pulled together. I would like them to start down here. Do we have any scouts? Yeah, we do. Back at base. Freebie scouts. Alright, I want scouts up here. And I want the other unit of scouts down here at the other pass. Bike unit, same deal. I want you guys positioned at the passes. I want to know where they're coming from. Let's get our artillery deployed. Up front.
Never surrender. Move out!
Let's spread you out a bit.
Understood, sir.
So we can have fields of fire. I want both sections covered. Alright, how are you doing?
One kill. Nothing deadlier than a clone behind the trigger.
Siege battalion.
General, what are we waiting for? Copy that.
We're gonna move you up here.
Roger that, sir. Yes, General. Copy that.
Get in here.
Combat is a clone's natural
move south.
Element.
The real trick is getting eyes on all the entrances and exits.
Let's move on. Weapons check.
Because the artillery can't fire if they can't see it.
Stay frosty.
Which kind of
prepare to engage the enemy.
Ruins their advantage. Alright, our turret's online. Second she's online. We do have enemy units. Requesting fire support. There we go. Good hit, good hit.
Watch the rear. Okay, here we go.
Solid, solid hit. What do we got? Our artillery, where is she?
She
should still be on the move. Artillery, good hit. Gonna need another round here. Our boys are starting to take fire. Deploy you. There's Dirge. Just got smacked in the face. I think I have backup for you, don't I? Yes, I do. Let's go. Come here. Quickly. He might actually be in range. Deploy. Take cover, siege battalion. Open fire. Get out of that shit. I don't know what that is. Oh, I used the stim pack and they were too damaged. Damn it, that's not good. Turbo lasers are gonna be able to hold them off though. Do we have any more of the siege battalion okay? Yes, we do. All clumped up right here. Let's spread you boys out. I need you moving. Dirge is already making his way through the base. Oh, he's not gonna make it. You can't take a turbo laser tower.
Our base is under attack.
It seems I have been outmatched. Never surrender. Move out!
Speaking about the game mechanics, when I was just thinking about the Battlefront sequel. If they did that kind of mode where you had this persistence to the gameplay, like you're actually fighting over the galaxy, the ability to promote players into hero characters permanently per campaign would be pretty fucking cool. Right? Like, if you've got people who are just really team players, they're communicating with command, they are just, they're really into it, then I could promote them to certain units like Anakin if you're doing the Clone War campaign, or if I were playing as the Empire, Darth Vader, or Luke Skywalker, or Rogue Squadron, if they're really into flying the fighters and they're damn good, and send them on, you know, special ops. That would be badass. Looks like the enemy isn't bringing in any type of air units. I don't really need to build anything here. Some ground troops. See if we can sneak in and capture their base. Let's speed this up. They're taking their sweet time.
Weapons check.
Just a couple of B2s. By a couple, I mean a shit ton. Nothing insane. Go ahead and capture this. We're going to eliminate their ability to reinforce. Let's move some of our clone troopers up.
Let's move on.
See if we can, there they go. Artillery took them out. Oh shit, we got bombers coming in.
We're ready for battle, sir.
We're never going to be able to move you out of the way in time.
Never give up. We'll follow you anywhere.
Run! Oh, we saved one. We're okay. Ah, damn, look at that.
Move out, men.
Deploy, deploy.
We're proud to serve you, General.
All right. Oh, good timing to stop. Dig in, hold position.
Okay, here we go.
We're going to give you some backup. Just hold this position, boys.
We do our job well.
We've got this. Come on now. Hold the line.
Construction complete.
Seriously? Like, get the turret online. There we go. Follow your unit back. Fall back. You beat to hell. Cover the main unit. There we go, your squad. Ooh, they've almost got 50% casualties. Not good, not good. They're gonna win though. Now it's an episode of the Clone Wars. Half the clones are dead. What do we got? Main group's coming through, but I never got that artillery down here.
Destroyed.
One shot.
We've got a unit here. They can get there pretty quickly.
Right away, sir.
As for artillery.
Yes, General.
None of my artillery actually got that far south.
Combat is a clone's natural element.
I can bring you here to replace him, and I can undeploy him and move him out, but it's gonna take too long.
Good.
I will do an official video once I have everything straightened out on, like, how the Star Wars thing's gonna work with meeting me at at the celebration, the Star Wars celebration. I'm really looking forward to it. One year. And I saw this in a video. I wasn't actually able to go. I've never been able to go to Star Wars Celebration before. They had a full-size TIE fighter. It was like 2.5 stories tall.
Okay, here we go.
How cool is that? Like, oh man, I'm excited. So I'm gonna try to do some video footage of it. I will use Twitter to like organize where we're gonna have a meetup.
Audit, sir. Yes, sir. Right away, sir. Prepare to engage the enemy.
So that should be a lot of fun. So expect that, and an actual video talking about, like, the dates and... Why the hell is the enemy? We took their base. I just turned it on fast forward. Our defenses should be able to hold. Good. He's down. Take them out. You guys are really good at taking out B2s. Just do it. Get it done. They're looking good. Where's our scout bikes? There they are.
Copy that. Roger that, sir.
Let's go.
Copy that.
You guys are able to find units.
Let's move
on.
Whoa.
Deploy.
We've lost a landing zone.
Don't worry, we'll have eyes on in just a second.
Clones,
there you are. There's the win. I love the artillery. Like, that map is just so good for artillery. Return to game. So the plan is to get the fleet here and begin the campaign to take Geonosis. Looks like I'm going to be pushing full hard and heavy on that. We are not going to take these two planets. We're going to leave them as is the second we can move the fleet. Just not worth it. I want to break their ability to produce units, not like throw my guys away.
God,
seriously? Where? I really want to move this unit. What are you bringing in? Oh, noes. That's a decent sized group. Providence class and a destroyer. I could take this on, but I'd have to pull the fleet back on Yavin. But that's what they're for. We're gonna auto resolve. We're gonna move the fleet back.
Moving to location.
Enemy.
As soon as she gets into the hyperspace lane, we'll be able to rock them quickly. I can't give orders while it's paused. That's why this is so irritating. Let's try to get you en route.
Right away.
All right, where are they coming in at? Come on, come on, come on! Hit the hyperspace lane. Get there before they hit us. Get there before they retreat. Because if I can get there, I can wipe the fleet and then kill the reinforcements.
Tactical battle.
There we go. Nice. Time to win a space battle. Production price reduction on this planet. They're not taking this from me. I wonder how much ARC troopers cost if you don't own this planet.
Space station damaged.
Because they're about 200 credits right now.
Tell me where to go. Day won't come when the droid
army. All right, they're pretty clustered right now. Let's move up.
I agree. Let's move.
Oh, your voice just doesn't match. It's so wrong.
We should move quickly.
We should move quickly. They're telling me there was no voice samples for Shakti. I mean, I guess not. The only game or anything that I can think of her in where she talked was, I think she had a couple of lines in the Clone Wars in the last season. I think she did. I'm pretty sure she did. With Fives. I think it was Fives. When his buddy had the chip go nuts in his brain. And then she had a deal, I think that's where she dies, actually, in the one with Starkiller. I can't think of the name now. Wow, Shaq. Let me know in the comments below. You know the game I'm talking about. The Force Unleashed. Force Unleashed 2. That's the one. I think she had some lines in that, because I think she actually dies in that.
I agree. Let's move.
All right, let's go, guys. Clear the path with the fighter cover. Move the fighter cover forward and clear the path. Like, look at that. You let a bomber through, and he actually launched a bomb. How dare you? I also need to move the arcs forward so they can start doing some serious damage once we clear out all the fighters. Close your wings. They're gonna keep trickling. Keep on trickling in, that doesn't bother me. Take out all your fighters, that doesn't bother me one bit. All right, let's move in, cause some trouble. I want your position right here. It should be getting within firing range, right? Watch it, we got civilian ships here. Ready for orders, Commander. I've got him lined up. Missiles are away. Oh, I love the Victory class's bombardment range is really nice. Yeah, try to take out his shield generator. Arcs, what the hell, guys? Take out his shield generator. Now, normal fire will actually take him down. Good stuff.
I read you, General.
We're looking good, we're looking good. Bring in the arcs. Look at that lineup. I don't know, for me, the one problem I've always had with Battlefield, and I'm probably way in the minority on this one, is that it never had the persistence. I never felt like it mattered. I'm always fighting these round after round, it's the same map, it's the same units, the same side. Oh, I died, who cares? Hey, I won the battle, that's fine. Good, great, wonderful. You get fun moments, but in the grand scheme of things, I never felt like I was getting anywhere. I like persistence, I like a reason to fight. It's one of the reasons why I played Eve for so long. I felt like I could make a difference. I don't know how much difference I actually ended up making with the units that I played with, but at least it was a battle, you know? There were supply lines that could be cut. There were targets to take out. When I killed an enemy ship, it meant something. It would cost them resources and time investment. And so, I don't know. That's what I'd love to see in Battlefront, is persistence. Some type of persistence for the multiplayer. So if we can all feel like we're making a difference. We're actually fighting for a reason. We're taking this planet. We're fighting over this resource point for a purpose. In the grand scheme of the campaign. Just something I'd like to see. And I want third person mode to come back. Alright, so we stopped the enemy invasion of our planet. Our secondary fleet has been getting work done. Which is good. Which is very good. Let's do... The main fleet is on the move. About to get to Sullust. We can bring the main fleet here to Naboo and clean these guys out. I like this plan a lot, actually. How are we doing on production? Are we still building ships? Looks like we need to put a new order in.
Constructing unit.
So let's do it. Let's get a new order for ships in.
Vehicle in production.
Let's get some arcs. Let's just throw some money into some arcs. I like it. And let's get the fleet moving again. As soon as they get there. Damn, they still beat me. I unpaused for 2 seconds and they beat me. Really? Really? Like, this is what your plan is? To bring in a couple of your, your battleships and a carrier? Oh, damn it. What level space station is this? I don't think we're gonna win this, boys. It's a level 1 space station. Auto-resolve it. It's not worth the time and effort. Move the fleet. Imminent. This is worth it. Let's see if we can auto-resolve this. Damn. See, auto-resolve and they get away. Imminent. Holy crap. What the hell? It's all fighters. That's a big group, though. It's a big group of fighters, but it's a big group. If they took this group... Oh, they did. They actually separated it from here. If they got all these fleets together, they might stand a chance in stopping my main fleet. If they gathered them together. We don't want that to happen. We're going to go ahead and auto-resolve. We're going to move the main fleet in. Okay, let's go.
On my way.
They're probably moving ground troops. They are moving ground troops. They're already en route. Go, 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 go.
Recon unit operational.
While this is heading on, we need to move our ground troops. What's left of them? Oh, Naboo. Oh, no. They're going to take Naboo from us. The fleet is on the way right now. I couldn't get there in time. Damn. Shit. This is where this game needs a stall mechanic, right? An enemy fleet or a friendly fleet is on the way. Reinforcements. All I have to should be able to do is hold out. That's all I should have to do is hold out until the fleet gets there. On some type of timer. But no, I actually have to win this or they're going to take it. And that means I'm going to have to do another ground invasion. All right, so what do we have? We have a barracks, we do have a light ground factory, and we've got turbo lasers. We've only got one group of clones stationed here to defend this. It doesn't look like they're bringing in the spider walkers, which is their only real big advantage. We should have the Gungan army and the you guys know what I'm talking about, the defense force, the Naboo Royal Defense Guard. That's the ones. With one eye, what's his name? I don't know if he's still alive in this era. That's a Clone Wars, of course he is. Let's get it done. We've got don't worry guys, the Gungan army will save us. Ugh. Just imagine that tactical briefing, right? You got all the generals standing around, the enemy fleet has arrived, and that one like lieutenant's like, well sir, the Gungans have an army. Don't worry, they'll help defend. It's like, shit. Gungans, okay. Alright, let's move in. I gave the Gungan shit, but to be honest, their army was actually pretty cool. The only one I had a problem with was Jar Jar. It's like, man, I know you want this to be kid-friendly, Lucas, but what the hell, dude? Alright, what do we got? Royal Defense Force. What are you guys actually called? Royal Naboo Security Troopers. Get over here. Got civilians here too.
Moving ahead.
Naboo civilians.
We've secured a landing zone.
If you so say so, as you so
if used to say so. They got these sounds from. Oh God, what was that? It was Empire. Galactic Warfare? No, it was the Age of Empires 2 skinned Star Wars game. Galactic Battlefront? Oh man, I don't remember. I just installed this not too long ago because I wanted to play it. There was this Age of Empires 2 game. It was built on that engine. It was literally Age of Empires 2 with a Star Wars skin, and it had the Gungans you could play as, it had the clone troopers, it had the Empire. Holy Shazbot. Here we go. Hold this point. We have
our base is under attack.
A bunch of scrap metal walking toward us. This is hilarious. Goodbye, guys. Run away! Roger, roger.
Sir, I'll do my best.
All right, gents, hold the line.
I'm here.
Look at the security forces and the civilians holding their territory, and they're just gonna walk right through us. What did you do? Don't let them through.
We do our job well.
All right, we've managed to make it to their drop point. Take it. Take and hold. Man, they've got a lot of ground troops. It's all right, guys. Don't worry. The regulars are here.
This battle isn't over until we've scrapped the last clanker.
The clones are like, really, guys? The Royal Guard? Are you guys just going to let them through? Take them down. Such a clusterfuck. How we doing over here?
I don't think the general would approve.
Are we holding? Yes, we are holding, but only because we've got these clone troopers on the scout walkers holding position. How you guys doing? Commander. Can you take them out? See that those reinforcements don't make it?
Where should I go?
Yes, General.
Hold the ground, clones.
Combat is a clone's natural element.
Get over here and support them. They're getting around us. Can't let that happen.
Oh, there's gonna be a firefight.
Hey, you got B1s here. You can take these. I know you can. I have faith.
Is under attack.
How are we doing? How have we not captured this? And stopped the reinforcements from coming in. This is like the most chaotic battle. You still tracking them down? Yeah, take the group that's behind you down. Let's see if the turbo lasers can snipe those guys before they get too far away. I don't want to chase them around. We have lost a defensive battery, but it looks like we're doing pretty good. Gungans, move quickly. They managed to cap that. Actually, they managed to neutralize it. They didn't bother actually capping it. It's a little weird.
We've lost a build pad.
All right, we're taking out their reinforcements. Ready for battle, sir. Pretty quickly. What are we doing back here? Hello, troopers. Get on it. The heck are you?
Watch the rear.
Speeder pilot. This army right here.
Never give up.
Good. All right, take them down. You guys are like walking together. Drop them. This should be the last squads they've got.
We'll follow you anywhere, sir.
And you guys can get out of cover because you're getting outrun.
Understood, sir. This is what clones do.
Turbo laser tower? Yeah, let's take it down. Alright, we're looking good.
Let's go. Following your lead.
We're looking damn good. I do hope they have a commander mode in Battlefront. I really do. I want to see that, and I want to see the dropships. The idea that the community is all playing together has me super stoked. The enemy has what, one unit left? Yeah, let's speed this up. Let's get the fleet in here to make sure this doesn't happen again.
Move on. Move out, men. You can't negotiate with droids. Copy that, General.
Probably one unit left. Yep. One unit left. Maybe two.
Okay, here we go. Understood, General. One shot.
Bark speeder. Find them. Is that it? We can call that a win? Nope, we got one left. Where are they? Two B1s.
Let's go.
Now there's still more out there.
Copy that.
The Joy, Republic of War, trying to find that last damn unit.
Copy that, General. Nothing deadlier than a
clone. There we go. Target identified. There's the win. Damn. I was really worried they were gonna take that. I was sitting there going, no way. Am I gonna have to like take this planet back, build a ground troop, reinforcement group? And here's the space battle.
Tactical battle.
You can't say the Republic didn't have fast reaction time when Naboo started screaming for help. The Senator will be pleased.
Check your weapons. We've got incoming.
Check your weapons. It's a lot of weapons. Comes those fighter squadrons.
Come when the droid army can outfight us without a 10-to-1 advantage.
In numbers. 10-to-1 advantage in numbers, maybe.
Bearing, sir.
Yes, sir.
What's my destination?
But gear and equipment, strategy, planning?
Ready for your orders.
They got nothing on
what
us.
Is your order?
Overload the cannons. See the tractor beam. I rarely use the tractor beam. So close ranged. You're awfully tough for a soft shell.
Keep your eyes open. Package ready for delivery. Thrusters at full.
They're retreating. Don't let it happen. Get it done, guys. Don't let it happen. Seriously, how are we not? We haven't taken his engines out. Oh, he almost got away. It's like one ground unit got away. Unacceptable. Unacceptable. All right, let's pause this right here. We're gonna call this the end of the episode. I think we're about an hour in. The ground, or the space army, the first fleet is on the way to Geonosis. Finally, we're gonna be able to relieve Kamino, who has been under constant assault, along with Tatooine. We're gonna get in there and finally free Tatooine and eliminate this giant pocket of enemy resistance that we've had in Geonosis. And that once Geonosis is captured, we're finally gonna have a breathing room on this side of the galaxy. We'll be able to focus our efforts. The last capital that the enemy has, the last two, I think, before we can call this a victory, is Mandalore. Mandalore's gonna be a hell of a tough fight, I think. Mandalore's always a tough fight. Doesn't matter who you are. Taking Mandalore is going to be a priority. We used to have Mandalore at the beginning of the campaign, but that didn't go too well. They took it back from us. We also used to have Mon Calamari, but they were able to secure that as well. So those are the two main planets. Are there any other planets, other than Mentuni, Mon Calamari, that I need to focus on taking? No, I think that's it. Trandoshan, Free the Wookiees, needs to be a thing. And before we make this push, we've got to get to Kashyyyk. We've got to grab up our Wookiee brethren, the Wookiee War Parties, because they are badass. They are so good. Strong against everything, because they're friggin' Wookiees. Alright guys, if you like where the campaign's going, let me know in the comments below. If you've got any suggestions on how I should be fighting the war, also let me know. I've learned so much from you guys in this. You guys are my war council. As always, thank you guys for watching, and I will see you in the next episode of Republic at War.